So good morning. Did we start already? Okay. My name is Lucio Capece. I come from Argentina, in Berlin, since 10 years. And what I have performed in this series that my friend Juho organized is a piece called Zero Plus Zero. The piece is based in the use of my instruments, soprano saxophone and bass clarinet, and analog electronics, combined with preparations. I started using preparations as a way to develop the possibilities of my instruments in a creative way, just to refine them, to redefine how I use them, how they can produce sound, a way to know them also, how they function. The instruments have been created for producing certain kinds of music, and I was wishing to produce other kinds of music, so I had to somehow redefine the instruments according to my needs. In the beginning, I was thinking being creative with them, and I developed a lot of sounds and I think the instruments began to sound in a different way, and even in a way that I had never seen or listened to any other saxophone bass clarinet player to play now, which was something that I wanted to do, to happen. But then at some point, this is something that happens, I think, in music history and in my own history. At some point, it became clear a question, you can say a problem. And this question is what makes you move towards something else. You can refuse it and stay forever doing the same thing. But for me, it's very important to do a music that is alive, to put questions and to take them as a way to make an alive music, always. So the question that I was making was, how much did the listener experience when I was performing a concert? And I found out that a lot of listeners get impressed by the use of the preparations, and the preparations take a lot of concentration. Then I realized that a way to develop the use of the preparations and the objects was to try to understand which tones they had inside. And also I began to find a way to use tones trying to pay attention to the noises that they could make. This is began to be a way to relate the use of objects and the instrument, and the objects as symbols of noise, and the instrument as a symbol of pitch, which is something that interests me in a social way. I tend to find instruments like something has been created for music that somehow excludes the sounds from the outside. Music is performed usually in places for music and tends to be isolated from the social life that happens outside the concert halls. And to me, the music exists everywhere. So I was thinking, how could I make the sounds from everywhere be part of the concert hall? It's something that I think a lot about the social behavior of us musicians. I think the 20th century has been a moment of hyper-specialization, and any scene, and especially the so-called avant-garde scene, produces culture for people who are involved or are part of that scene. I was wondering in which way I can become interesting or enjoyable for people who are not part of that scene. I want to relate with the world, not only with people like me. So the use of objects can be criticized by some people who are part of the scene and who are somehow thinking that there is an elegance in the use of the instruments in a pure way, which is something that I agree at a certain degree. But also, I like to corrupt the instruments and to think that an object that arrives to my life and gives me a beauty is as important as the instrument, as is as important to me to learn from musicians and from people more experienced, as much as I learn from everybody in real life. I find so many artists playing their instruments as I find people doing their jobs with love. I think they are artists also. So the same thing I think about objects, and I think it's very beautiful to let them arrive to my life and to think in which way they do music with me. So the composition is called 0+0 because it's the link between the instruments and the objects. And it's zero because what the emphasis is in how they connect, isn't the plus. I think it's more important that thing than the objects and the instruments itself, how we relate, how we people relate. I think it's more important even than music. But by the other way, I have to say, I can play music that I consider very abstract. And when we go to a concert, we listen, but we also watch, and we inhabit a space. And I have to say that the use of the objects became a way to play very abstract music for people who are not part of that scene or who are not familiar with that language. And somehow the possibility to watch familiar objects helps me to relate with anybody. I think I can play these pieces in any context. I have played it even for kids, and the kids were interested and listening to me, like if how I listen to somebody playing some very abstract music. And this is not done in a demagogic way. I don't want to convince them about anything. The music, it's not easy music, it's not easy to listen, it's slow, it's quiet, it's demanding. But for some reason, if you find something that is part of your life, then you are part of it. And this is something that I want to happen. So now I can show you some of these objects that I use and how I use them, and how they relate. What I was doing in the beginning was use this box that is 100 CDRs box that I put here. I put this radiography here because I put a ball on it and I make it move this way. This produces a noise. If I take this carbon tube, this noise changes. Of course, if I change the position of the tube, the timbre, and a little bit, the pitch that is hidden changes. But I can recognize that this combination of these four objects, that is the instrument, the CD box, the ball, and the carbon tube, produce a pitch. That is this one. It's difficult to recognize, but now if I do it with this other tube, you will see the difference. So I will do it this. And now play the tone. That is the main tone here. That is this one. Of course, I also play the instrument doing this. I'm just producing tones. And if I use the lower register of the instrument, I can make this shake in this way. Well, in this case it works more like a mute, but if I put this, this is something that I take from a termo. We say in Spanish, I use it to drink mate, but I took it and I put it here. It fits exactly in this little thing that has this. I'm going to show the camera. No, it has this. And this has a hole here. So this fits here. And it doesn't fall down. And then with the ball and next. Several of these boxes, and they produce different reactions. I have them at home, of course. I travel with one of them. But I also have different kinds of balls. In this case, for example, the balls have a very clear pitch. This one has another kind of pitch. And I can play this in the bass clarinet. This ball almost doesn't sound, but if I play it like this, I think it's very beautiful what happened, because it almost doesn't sound, and then the ears of the audience, when you play so quiet, they wake up and they tend to listen a lot to the room. So there is a kind of interesting contradiction when you play very quiet music and when you use this object that is considered an object that distracts you from the music. But actually it almost doesn't sound. And then you watch it and you make the effort to listen, and then many things that happen around us become very important, and this is something that I really like to happen. This one, even this, I took from a mouse, a computer mouse, is the one that makes the mouse roll, and it's a bit more heavy, and it has another kind of sound. That's a singer. It's not the ball. I couldn't reach that yet. This one sounds even quieter. These sounds can be amplified sometimes, but honestly, I prefer to play them acoustic. Then another use that another way of using the instruments can be, the objects can be to put the carbon tube inside the bell of the instrument. As I told Juho, I used to use this carbon tube to protect the bow. But then one day I tried the carbon tube and I liked very much the sound. It's very low. And I began to find multiphonics that can relate with it. Sometimes the multiphonics play the same tone, but sometimes they resolve in the way you have a chord that resolves into another one. You have I try to find tones or multiphonics which main tones resolve into some of the noises, into the main pitch that you have when you produce one of these noises. Yeah, classic resolution. But then I found out that this object can be also prepare itself. So I use, for example, this is to construct small speakers. And I can make it shake. Or I can put earplugs on it. So you have the speaker and the earplugs together. Another use is, this is a cocktail shaker. The cocktail shaker has two parts, this one and this one. I have bought many cocktail shakers, and any one sounds as good as this one, believe me. This part, for example, I can make. Of course, if I do it very quiet, and if I don't put any resin in the bowl, it brings only a few partials. If I press it a bit more and I'm more constant, it brings a more clear pitch and a higher frequencies. And I try to find multiphonics that I relate with it. If I use this part, it becomes more like a bell. This other shaker also fell in my hands, was present of the father of my girlfriend. And I couldn't find it sounding because it touches the tube, but it makes this. But this one is too heavy to do that sound. This is also became very important, and I couldn't find anyone as light as this one. Then I began to attach things, for example, this chain. And if I take a bit of tape, I can put this here. And then this little chain touches the carbon tube and a little bit of the bass kind of bell. I can also make a tone come. And if I put this here, also another thing that I do sometimes is to use a radiography. Radiography makes this sound. Now there are some beautiful sounds coming from outside, a singer, I don't know the other thing. So in order to play with them and finish with this talk, I'm going to use this beautiful hand fan that I got in Japan. Thank you.